I get into discussions about index investing versus stock picking versus trading all the time. And while I am a huge advocate for index investing, what I am telling you today is that index investing is for losers. But after dropping that bombshell, I also want to tell you how you can become the smartest person in the room simply by doing one thing, tossing a coin. Index investing is exclusively the preserve of losers. There's no winners here, it's just a big giant L. That statement may come as something of a surprise to you if you follow my blog, Twitter, or YouTube, or anything like that for any length of time. I've been investing in index funds for nearly 3 years now, and as a result, pretty much all my investing is now in low-cost ETFs just to track the market across the globe. Pretty much every year that goes by, I am proven to be a big old loser. Does that bother me? No. Do I think that will prevent me from being successful as an investor? No. Do I think that index investing is going to get me to where I want to be? Absolutely yes. So why am I all right with being such a tube? Well, let me explain. Index investors come in for an awful lot of stick, and here's why. It's boring. It's really drab. It's lights out at 10 p.m. on a school night. Anyone looking in on any portfolio updates will surely see that they are turgid owl affairs. If you've seen one, you've seen them all. And I know they are boring because I've done them myself. It's hard to get excited about another few quid being thrown into an all-world tracker every month. Consequently, it's even harder to get other people excited about watching that sort of thing. It's uninspiring, it's insipid, it's tedious, it's enough to make you feel like a loser. Nothing spicy. Well, look, all that's a little bit anecdotal, a little bit melodramatic, but it's true, index investors are losers pretty much every year, and here's why. The first reason is that index trackers are there to track a market. They're never made to beat it. You will never beat the index with an index tracker, but rather sit ever so slightly below the benchmark it's trying to track. You're going to sit slightly below in the good times and the bad. For example, let's take a look at Vanguard's VUSA, VUSA. If it rose 12% over the last 10 years, then you could expect your return to be something very close to that 12%, but just not quite on it. It feels slightly, I'll say it again, boring. From this point of view, it's all a bit always the bridesmaid, never the bride kind of thing. Here's reason number two why index investing is for losers, because every year index investors have to look around and see some other asset class or some particular stock flying and dwarfing their meager returns. In 2020, ARK Innovation and Cathie Wood became the talk of the town as her ARK fund bettered all in front of it. Enormous returns, absolutely huge. If you were in on that or had some way to replicate that, then that's great and good for you. I wasn't though, and so there were lots and lots of people telling me I should have been. Cathie Wood had an absolutely amazing 2020, but I had to put up with my loser market returns while Cathie Wood and her squad turned everything they touched into gold. It's not going so well right now, but that's not my point. The point is, in 2020, my index fund was a loser. I could have had better. Maybe I should have shown more guts. Maybe I should have got my magic coin out again. I'll get to that very soon. So if 2020 was all about Cathie Wood, then 2021 was the rise of crypto once again. My Twitter feed full of rockets, laser eyes, to the moon shouts, you know, seems you could pick any old Ponzi scheme you wanted and get rich. On paper at least. I had lots of crypto specialists celebrating their victories, and I'm glad for them. Genuinely glad. But there was I, stuck once again with my sad old index trackers. I made the decision not to go in and buy strong and stuck with it. I hope people got out of that in time, but that's another issue altogether. The point is, I had to sit on the sideline and watch people with impeccable timing make a fortune buying magic internet beans with dog faces all over them. The simple scenario is that every year something will beat your humble index tracker. That's a fact. Get used to the reality that something is going to beat it. It could be another stock, it could be real estate returns, crypto, it could even be bank interest. Rest assured, your index tracker will lose against the best performing asset of that year. And above all else, you can be absolutely certain that someone else is going to tell you about it. I just need to have a little bit of faith in being an index investing loser, because the thing is, you're unlikely to be a loser to the same thing 2 years in a row, and almost certainly not over the long term. The reason is, it's very hard to keep getting it right. Cathie Wood is a good example. Flew so high in 2020 and has struggled a little bit since. Her company and her products might well come back. Nobody knows for sure. Nobody's a fortune teller. But to do better than an index investing loser like me, you're going to have to keep on making the right decisions, leaping onto the right asset from time after time after time. But it's hard, you know, it's a tough old station to be an index investing loser. It's hard to appreciate that there will always be something that beats you. It's hard to accept that your index tracker will never, ever, not once in your investing life likely to be the top dog asset. Even in the best index investing year you will ever have, never will your index tracker be the king. But look, let me offer you an alternative outlook and some hope in index investing. Let me assume you are indeed a long-term investor. You saw the title and the thumbnail of this video and you clicked the video looking for a fight, because that's what we do on the internet, isn't it? Therefore, I will also assume you are buying your index funds because you believe in diversified, appreciating assets, and you were ready to let rip in the comments below about just how much of an idiot I actually am. So let me also tell you then that the simple index investing strategy is very unlikely to be beaten over the long term by pretty much anything. An index fund isn't sexy, but over time it has proven to be pretty much the best way to invest. Many people have tried to beat it, but few have over the long term. Sure, one or two could have a few good years where things run well, and one or two might even have a run where they look just about unstoppable. Eventually though, the market catches up with them. Even the brightest and the best can't beat the market over a long period of time. Nearly 90% of fund managers can't beat the market over 15 years. What makes you think you can? And I hate to bring up our mate Cathy Wood again, but she had a stellar 12 to 18 months which catapulted her into the limelight when honestly very few had heard of her before that. But this wasn't the first time someone had gained massive popularity because of an amazing short-term run. Which brings me round to becoming the smartest person in the world by doing this one thing. We're back to our coin. So let's say you have a room of 128 people. I'm holding a regular coin here, just a regular old 50p. Well, not one of those rare ones worth thousands of pounds. Nope, just a normal 50p from my index investing ISA. I'll be putting it back there after this. But a normal 50p piece. Heads or tails, I'll ask the room. 64 will say heads, 64 will say tails. Half the room are eliminated. We're down to 64, and with that 64 then we'll get half the room to go with heads and half the room to go with tails, and we'll flip it once more. So now we're down to 32 correct answers. We go again, we're down to 16, then 8, then 4, then 2, and then 1. The one that is left is the one who made all the calls correctly, and that's the fund manager you will hear about in the news. That's the Cathy Wood. Or it could be the guy who went all in on Dogecoin at just the right time. This is survivorship bias, the idea that the subgroup, the successful few, are somehow representative of the many. But the fact is that it's incredibly hard to be right all the time. The true representation of the many here are the 127 people who lost everything trying to get it right time and time again. This is why I am happy to be the perpetual loser when index investing in the stock market. I'll take my market wins and losses, I'll continue to invest for the next 10, 20 years and check back sometime later in the future rather than chase the next new hotness. Because while the past is no guarantee of future performance, my index investing and my trackers that I put my money into are built on strong companies that have been around for a long, long time. They've been making money for years and years and years. And I'll take that over trying to win the lottery any day. Right, so I'm off to put my 50p back in my ISA and be a borebag somewhere else. I'll see you later. You're the best around. No one's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. No one's gonna ever keep you down.